Okay, welcome back guys, let's push on and try and finish this tower as quickly as possible. Let's see, more snowmen. Thankfully these are the magic type. The magic types don't do as much damage to us because we worked on getting our magic resistance up. Normally these guys might do a few thousand damage, but thanks to our magic resistance it's been brought back to a few hundred. Let me check. Where does that go again? Oh yeah, snowman. Yeah, these are the food types, yep, okay. I know where I am, which is very important. Almost as important as knowing where your towel is. Oop, just food, so kill them. So yeah, our fighter experience is about 107,000, our wizard experience is 127,000. And another hammer as well, which as you know will increase our strength. So that's very nice, and we will push onward to the left, definitely, but... Oh yeah, yep. We'll go left and then left again first. Check in the next part. I'm not sure if you guys can even hear the game sounds, to be honest. I'll have a look at that next, between the next part. Okay, so yeah, we do want to get these as well. Oh, damn it, I shouldn't have shot that key. That's a bit of a pain. Oh well, sorry for the little delay, I was just looking at the map for a second. See if it was still worth going in here, but just getting that spell scroll down there is going to be worth it, I guess. And of course a pendant, which is also very nice. And the next room, there's some myconids, and they drop poison and not much else. And we don't really need the rod, so we're going to ignore that little that little area. There's nothing of significant value up there. Up here, on the other hand, is something of value. You know what? I think at this stage it's going to be worth using a red potion. By the way, we picked up 10 extra wisdom, so let's see the difference. The last time we healed, we got 20,000 hit points, I think. So we're at about 20 now. So now it's 35,000. Which is already much better. A part of that is due to our experience from having used one of the red potions before, but a large part of that is because our wisdom went up by 10 points as well. You know what, just leave it equipped, just in case. Okay, so now we go up, and then right, yeah. Okay, mudmen. Sometimes mudmen are very valuable, the moving types. In this case, that is not the case, because they are lamp types. But I might just kill the last one with my sword anyway, just to get some experience in. Maybe I'll be able to hit it from the side, I was going to say, but instead it hit me from the side, that's okay too. Oh yeah, striders. I think these are the poison type, aren't they? Oh no, these are the gold type. Yeah, very nice. At least we'll easily be able to afford a healer when we get out, and maybe some other stuff. Might be worth starting to save up for more magic as well. Right at the moment we don't need anything, but in the following levels it might be useful to get... yeah, we'll go straight up. To get another stronger dex spell for the really annoying enemies. We don't really have any in level 5. We don't have any enemies that use strong magic attacks or stuff like that. But in the following levels that might become a bit of a problem again. Oh yeah, spectacles, that's right. So now we will go here. Oh yeah, this next room is a little bit dangerous. Be very careful going in. Oh no, it's the one after that, I guess. don't remember which type these are. Let's take a spectacle and see if we're missing anything good. Nope, these are poison, so we'll kill them. I guess I forgot to write down one of these rooms. Oh well. And this one? Yeah, this is the one. Clearly a good place to visit if you have high karma, but we don't, so maybe we'll just kill them instead. And annoyingly, even these Mishtu guys will drop poison, so we'll take care of him as well. Do I want the glove? I guess so. I'll leave the other poisons around just in case we need them later to improve our karma. Ah, damn it. Oh, these aren't the gold types anyway. Are they? No. This one goes over here, so that's... Wait, let me see. Yeah, we do want to go left here. Yep, okay. I thought so, but I'm just checking. There we go. And another red potion to add to our collection. And let me show you one more. 32,000. 75,000. So already we're up to 40. So yeah, that... Just using a little bit of experience, it makes that kind of stuff go much better, using these items. They're definitely equally important to other concerns, like having a high wisdom. Oh man, I wasn't paying attention. And I actually had this written down, but I didn't look very carefully. Oh well, nothing we can do about it now. Thankfully we weren't at full health anyway. Sadly, it does mean we wasted that that red potion. But oh well, myconids. Oh, these are the food types, so let's get rid of them. Yeah, we do want to check down here as well. Some more pendants and some more other stuff down here. Unmoving mudmen, so we can take our time taking them out. I do want to kill the last one with a melee attack because they are pendant types. There we go. And then the final one, which will give us some extra gold. As you can see, you can sort of tell them apart by their movement patterns sometimes. This mudman moves different from any other mudman. So you know these are the gold types just by looking at them. And of course, often you can tell by how much experience they give you, or how much health they have, or stuff like that. Okay, so that's most of this tower cleared, or at least the stuff we're really interested in. From here on, we will head straight to the end of level boss, which is finally our first boss that isn't a Kraken. Before we do, of course, we'll waste a little bit of time picking up this mushroom, improve our chances a little bit. Some more of these guys, get some more gold, up to 60,000 already. So yeah, that 200 and some odd experience we need for our death spell suddenly isn't looking so far away. Let me just check real quick, these guys, yeah, pendant, so oops, we do want to try and get them out of the way like this. Hopefully, yeah, they won't kill us. Again, we're gonna need a couple of red potions to get our health back up. 15, 72, so we're close to 60,000 health now for one potion. definitely worth it. Yeah, just leave him equipped for now. I know. Some more of these guys. There we go. Wait, is this poison? Nope. Key. I'm going to have to be a little bit more careful from here on because we don't want to lose most of our health before we go into the boss fight. Thankfully our equipment is mostly up to date, so we don't have to worry too much. I think we'll be able to take him pretty easily. But still, you want to be a little bit careful. We have picked up a lot of elixirs. In the meantime, we're up to 4 now, and we'll get a couple more in the following levels. Oops, did I want to do that? Oh yeah, they were spectacles, so not important. Plus 2 small shield, which is useless to us now, although I'll show you what it looks like really quickly. It's not the nicest. It's a good thing we already have a better one. Okay, some more of these guys. I think these are the food types. I'll ignore them for now because we're kind of running low on time. And then we have some more Steropers, and then we will be there. Again, the money types, so definitely welcome. And this will be the entrance to our boss monster for level 5. And here we go. Now, as you can see, it's clearly family of the Kraken, but it's not him. Ooh, our magic is extremely strong against it. I wasn't expecting that. So we don't even have to use our melee attacks against this guy. We can just shoot him to death with our Tilda spell. By the way, it doesn't matter if you kill a boss with magic or melee attacks. You always get a set amount of experience in both types. You get a few thousand fighter and a few thousand wizard experience for killing any end boss. So it doesn't really matter how you kill it. Our reward is a little bit disappointing this time. We only get a crown, but since we needed to finish the game, we will take it. And that's the end of level 5. Again, if you're going to take these towers, definitely try and make a map before you go in, because otherwise you would have wasted a ton of keys to get here. As it is, we've wasted a ton of keys. I think like 16, 17 keys or something, maybe even more. So yeah, that's in the higher levels, it's not a luxury to have a map. Okay, let's trap him a bit. Yeah, that's probably the best advice I can give you right now. I will get out of the tower off screen. You don't really have to want to have to watch me do that. And oh yeah, let me just one more thing. Our defense is still a little bit lower than it was with our half plate, but it's almost the same now. And we're only at 40 experience compared to over 100 for our half plate. So yeah, it's definitely going to get a lot better quickly now. Okay guys, I think that's all for this tower. In fact, I'm pretty sure it is. Yep, because if we go down here, we go back to the exit. Yep. Okay, so thanks for watching again, guys. I hope you enjoyed this part. It's always nice to see a boss fight. And I will see you back in the next one.